So we did absolute value functions of linears. Now we got to look at, quadratics. And if you remember what a quadratic is, that's that y equals to ax minus p squared plus q stuff. Do you remember that? Where p and q was that vertex. And we also said that a tells us if it's opening up or down, narrow or wide. You know what might be a really good idea is go back to the podcasts on this way back in chapter 3 and take a look at this and watch just the introduction to this again. It might refresh your memories. Now, what's interesting here is what I want to do is this. I want to take the original. Now, before you absolute value it, I want to see what the original looks like. So this is x squared minus 4. That's your what your y equals to. Now, think about this for a second. If it's in this form, x minus p, this must be x minus 0 squared, because if it's 0, it's just x and x squared, which is exactly what we have right there. Okay? Minus 4. So our vertex must be 0 minus 4. There's our vertex. There's our p. There's our q value, right? Okay, so let's plot that in here right now. Go right down here to 4. 1, 2, 3. There's our vertex at 4. Now, also, we want to find the x-intercepts. And we're finding out the x-intercepts. You remember, y equals to 0. That gives us two possibilities here. You can go and say, okay, y being 0, x squared minus 4, there's our original equations. Okay, you can actually solve this algebraically by taking the 4 over here, right? X squared, square rooting, you got x equals to plus or minus 2. That's great. Or you can say, oh, well, x squared minus 4 is just a difference of squares. That's x minus 2. That's x plus 2. There's a difference of squares giving you your x plus or minus 2. I kind of like this way better, but one of the reasons why is because it actually shows you the plus or minus 2, whereas this one you have to remember that wonderful thing called square root principle, which could be just the nightmare. But anyways, there's your plus 2, there's your minus 2. So your graph kind of looks like this. Comes down this way, comes around, and goes up to something like that, right? Okay, so with that in mind here, think about it. You have a negative 4 as a y-intercept, and you know you're going to turn around and you're going to have to absolute value this. Absolute value of negative 4 is 4. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4. There's your new vertex. And the only way you can get that is if you flip this entire thing. So look, I'm going to take this whole thing right here, all the way around, and I'm going to flip this thing. So if it's U-shaped now, it's going to be that shape later, with this, of course, being your vertex. So look, we're just going to go up and we're going to flip the whole thing, and there's your new vertex. So what does your absolute value graph look like? Your absolute value graph should look like this. Boom, right like that. And I'll prove it to you very simply by putting it into your calculator. So looking at your calculator here, let's find the absolute value. So math, go over to num, there's your absolute value, put in your equation, which was x squared minus 4. So now you know it's in the absolute value. There's a nice vertical thing sitting right there. Hit graph. And look at that. There's your W shape. What I want to show you, though, is look, here is, in fact, 1, 2, 3, there's 4. There's your absolute value where your graph was originally, which is 1, 2, 3, 4. It was originally down here and looked like this, didn't it? Okay, so now it's up here at plus 4. And this section here is now this section here. This section here is now this section here. It was completely flipped, because if you have to remember, like one of the things you have to remember about absolute values is that nothing exists below this axis, right? Because everything down here was a negative value. And anything that's negative, remember, is absolute valued to make it a positive. That's why this thing flips. Okay, so with that in mind now, okay, let's do some interesting looks here. There's our positive 2. There is our minus 2. And look at this. This is really cool. I'm going to go back to this now. There's our positive 2 right here. There's our minus 2. And being that they're a x-intercept, we call those critical points. This is the point at which the graph changes. Okay, so your graph changed here and your graph changed here. So this is going to be interesting because, let me erase all of this. This will be interesting because this is where you're going to determine the critical points. This is where you're going to determine the piecewise function. Now think about this for a second. What is the piecewise function? The piecewise function says y equals 2. Y equals 2. Where was the graph original? Where was the graph normal? We said the original graph is when we dealt with it being plus. It was x squared minus 4 was our original graph. Well, where was the normal part of the graph? The normal part of the graph was here and here. That's the part that did not change. And look where it didn't change, at our critical points. So it was a normal part of the graph when x was greater than or equal to positive 2. So in other words, this section of the graph occurred in that direction. Look, it's even showing you I'm going this way to the right. Look at this, which was our original part of the graph, now going to the left at this critical point. So it's going now to the left at minus 2. Excellent. So there's your original part of the graph. Now, this is the part of the graph that was flipped. Where was it flipped? Between our two critical points. So it was flipped, making this a minus x squared minus 4. Where? Between our two critical points. Between minus 2 and positive 2, that's where x had to be, between those. So greater than negative 2 in this direction, less than positive 2 in that direction. And there's our piecewise function. So if you think about it, this particular thing, this piecewise function, this graph, because it's been absolute valued, has been switched into three distinct pieces. This piece, which was part of the original. That piece, which was part of the original. And now this new piece here, which was flipped. So we can clean this up even more and say, okay, our y equals to the original graph, which is this part here, okay, which was x squared minus 4 is our original graph, when x was greater than or equal to positive 2, and when x was less than or equal to negative 2. So in other words, this section greater than positive 2, this section less than negative 2. And then we also said it flips. So we can actually distribute it in there and say this is minus x squared plus 4, when x was between minus 2 and 2, our critical point, right? And that's how we get that particular thing happening for us.